Thank you. Thank you. I want you all to know that I would not be doing this right now if I didn't think that I could do a really good job as President of the United States. And I base that on my experience in life, and that starts with the fact that I've been an entrepreneur my entire life. Since I've been 17 years old, I've paid for everything that I've had in my life. When I was a junior in college, I started a one-man handyman business in Albuquerque, Maine, and actually grew that business to employ over 1,000 people. Electrical, mechanical. Plumbing, pipe fitting, architects, engineers. It's amazing how successful you can be if you show up on time and just do what you say you'll do for people. I sold that business in 1999. Nobody lost their job, and it allows me to have a full-time unpaid job running for president of the United States. A couple of takeaways being an entrepreneur. One of them is some advice that I'm going to give all of you this evening. It's worth exactly what you're paying for it, which is nothing. But my advice to all of you is that whatever it is that you're good at in your life, do it entrepreneurially. Be your own boss. The rewards are 100-fold. The impact that you have on others is much more dramatic. Again, advice I'm giving you that you're not asking for and worth exactly what you're paying for, which is nothing. One of the hardest things about being in business is hiring and firing. Hiring is really easy. Firing is really difficult. Mitt Romney said, "I love to fire people." I gotta tell you, I hate firing people. But if you can't fire people in the private sector, you're out of business. And in the public sector, it's really easy to not fire people. But if you don't do it, it just ends up being dysfunctional. And that's what we have right now. And that's what so exists in government, is because people that are in government have never hired and fired. I'm also an athlete. I've been an athlete my entire life. I have a goal to climb the highest mountain on each continent. I've had the good fortune to actually get to the top of Mount Everest. But here's the story on Everest, and here's a story that I think that I hope everybody can relate to. I broke my leg 2 months prior to going to Nepal. I mean, it was a full fracture of the tibia. And in a situation like that, which is a situation that all of us face all the time, which is nothing goes according to plan. Nothing. Expect that to be part of the plan. And when adversity presents itself, we all have choices when adversity presents itself. One of them is we just lay on the couch, feel victimized, and it's just not meant to be. The other is embrace it. Embrace it and recognize that there's always adversity, and those that make the most out of adversity are those that are successful. And that's what we need to recognize, and that's what we need to all do in our lives. I had never run for political office prior to running for governor of New Mexico. I mean, I was completely outside of politics. Totally. I went and I introduced myself to the Republican Party of New Mexico, John Latuzio, the head of the Republican Party in New Mexico. And what he said was, after talking to him for about 30 minutes, he said, "Man, Gary, I like you. I like what you've done. We're an inclusive party. We're going to include you in all the meetups. You can go on the traveling road show to try and become the nominee of the Republican Party. We greet you with open arms, but you just need to know that you will never get elected. That it's not possible to come from completely outside of politics and get elected governor in a state that's 2-1 Democrat." Well, I got elected. And I would like to think it was based on what I had to say, which was simply, let's bring a common sense business approach to state government. Best product, best service, lowest price. Less government is better government. Keep government out of the bedroom. And don't allow government to make decisions for me that only I should be making. It made a difference when it came to government telling you or I what we could or couldn't do.